Shalom, everyone. My name is Rabbi Nancy Tunick. I'm having a few technical problems this evening, and so please let me know if you can see and hear me. I have an extremely slow internet connection for some reason, so everything is just taking a long time. But we will be using the Rabbi Nancy Siddur on the right-hand side, which is actually the Reform Gates of Prayer. I am the rabbi at Temple B'nai Israel in Florence, Alabama, and I'm coming to you from Nashville, Tennessee. And I'm happy to be with you for this Wednesday Maariv service. Right now, I don't know if the chat function is functioning. And if not, we can use the social stream. I apologize. My laptop is extremely slow. Let's see if we have folks here that can see me. So in the chat function, if you can see and hear me, please let me know. I see that Albert is with us, but I'm not seeing a response back. We're going to use it for the Misha Berach and for the Mourner's Kaddish. And if we do continue to have trouble with it, we'll just go over to the social stream. And again, I apologize for the delay. Just trying to make either the chat function or the social stream function. Also make sure that we're all able to connect. Go over to the social stream. Well, if you can let me know. So interesting. But we will begin on page 2 of the Rabbi Nancy Gates of Prayer Siddur. And we will be celebrating the greatness of the Eternal One. It surpasses our understanding. And yet at times we do feel his nearness. Overwhelmed by awe and wonder as we behold the signs of his presence, still we feel within us a kinship with the divine. And so we turn to you, O God, looking at the world about us and inward to the world within us, there to find you and from your presence to gain life and strength. And we say together, Baruchu et Adonai Hamvarach, praise the Lord to whom our praise is due, Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Leolam Va'ed, praise be the Lord to whom our praise is due now and forever. You do see or hear me, let me know, or if there's any issue, just because it has been technically challenging. We're going to praise the greatness of God on page 3 as we sing together the Baruch. We say these key words in our tradition. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Hear, listen, O Israel. The Lord is our God, the Lord is one, Echad. Baruch Shem Kavod Malchuto Le'olam Va'ed. Blessed is God's glorious kingdom forever and ever. And on page 5, we sing Shema Yisrael, Adonai.
The Lord is our
continue with the Via Hafta on page 7 or 6, if you're going to chant it traditionally. 7, we have the English transliteration and interpretation. Via Hafta et Adonai Elohecha v'chol lucha v'chol nafshecha v'chol miyodecha. With all your mind, with all your strength and all your being, set these words upon your heart, teach them faithfully to your children. Speak of them in your home, speak of them on your way, when you are lying down and when you rise up. Tis karuv asitem, erhu, mitzotai, ve'yitem, kiddushin elohechem, ani Adonai Elohim. Tada, Albert, for letting me know that we are actually connected, and we will use the social stream for our feedback since we know that it is working. And Albert, I'm grabbing a fabulous week. We turn to page 9 and we read responsively. Infinite God, creator and redeemer of all being, you are most high, most near. In all generations, we have cried out to you. We have put our trust in you. We have borne witness to your truth before the nations. Oh, now let your light and your truth appear to us and lead us. Let them bring us to your holy mountain. And together we say, we shall not fear then, though earth itself should shake, though the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters thunder and rage, though the winds lift its waves to the very vault of heaven. We shall not fear, for you are with us. We shall rejoice in your deliverance. Then shall we know you, our Redeemer and our God, and in the shadow of your wings we shall sing with joy. We sing on page 11. Are you Master of Wonders? Nechamacha, Ha'ilim Adonai. Nechamacha, Nedar B'Kodesh. Nora Tehillot Usef. Most important prayer and sentiment in our times. Let there be love and understanding among us. Let peace and friendship be our shelter from life's storms. Eternal God, help us to walk with good companions, to live with hope in our hearts and eternity in our thoughts, that we may lie down in peace and rise up to find our hearts waiting to do your will. Together we say, blessed is the Eternal One, Guardian of Israel, whose love gives light to all the world. And if we all individually live with hope in our hearts and eternity in our thoughts, if we individually lie down in peace If we individually rise up to find our hearts waiting to do God's will, then collectively we will have peace in our time, and we will have love and understanding among us, and each individual light will combine to kindle the ultimate flame. And so we join our voices together for the Tefillah on page 14. Adonai, Sifata Tiftaf, Ufi, Yagita Hilate. Turn back to page 13 for the Avot. Together we read, Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu v'Elohei Avoteinu, Elohei Abraham, Elohei Yitzchak, v'Elohei Yaakov, Ha'el Hagadol Hagibor v'Hanora, El Elyon Gomel Hasadim Tovim, V'Konei Hakol V'Zocher Haste Avot, U'mei V'Geula Livnei V'Neihem L'ma'an Shemo V'Hava. Melech Chozer Mashiach U'magein, Baruch Ata Adonai, Magen Abraham. We turn now to page 16. It was a week of beauty so far. We had the opportunity in Nashville and in sort of a band through the country to see a total solar eclipse. We saw the moon pass in front of the sun. And it was a time of great beauty and awe. In this week's parsha, we are told actually not to worship the sun and the moon, ironically, but we are also told to appreciate the beauty and majesty of nature. And the reason why we don't worship it is because our appreciation is connected to worshiping God, and that God is the source of that beauty, and the reason for our awe. So we say,
help us see your beauty. It's just beyond our
Kadosh, 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 Adonai Tzvaot, Melecho Ha'aretz Kavodo. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The fullness of the whole earth is God's glory. And they respond to your glory with blessing. Baruch Kavod Adonai Mim Komo. Blessed is the glory of God in heaven and on earth. So we turn now to page 18, and we take an opportunity for a silent meditation. This is a chance to thank God for the beauty in this world and for the majesty of celestial events like our solar eclipse, for the love in our lives and our homes and our communities, for the possibility of peace and the hope for joy for eternity. Or it's an opportunity to quiet our minds. Our minds are rarely quiet in this day and age. And when we quiet our minds, that is when there is a chance to hear a still small voice within.
May the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable to you.
Keep that feeling in our hearts as we join our voices together for the Misha Berach, this feeling of hope and peace and love. When we combine our voices together, our sages say that our prayers travel that much faster to God's ears. And that is the same analysis for music, that when we sing our prayers, it also travels fast. Now, our technology is not traveling fast for this Maariv service. It is traveling slowly. So if you do have names for healing prayers, please type them into the social stream right now, as the chat function doesn't seem to be working. And we will sing Debbie Friedman's Misha Berach, and then we will pause to read the names. It's on page 20. And then we will continue with the rest. So we sing together.
Misha Berach.
For Zoe and Renee, for Alan and Lillian, for Mara and Taylor, Sherry, Blair, any other names for the Misha Berach, please type them in now. If you typed in a name And my very slow technology did not allow it to be read aloud. Please speak it out loud where you are. And if there are any other additional names, I will read them after we finish singing the Misha Berach, because I know everything is moving very slowly. So we continue at the bottom of page 20 onto page 21. Also extends to Valerie and Erin, Maddie, Trey, Mayo, Bonnie, Izumi, Malcolm, Rose, Albert, and Bobby. So we continue on page 22 with the Aleinu. Oh, let us continue on page 24 with the mourners' Kaddish, and we will be reading aloud the names of those whom we've lost. It's an opportunity for us to draw them closer to our lives. We light Yahrzeit candles and we commemorate the anniversary of the end of a life rather than the beginning as part of our Maariv and Shabbat services and as part of our tradition, because we commemorate everything that was done in a life. When we are born, we are filled with potential, but when we are gathered unto our people, we leave this earth, we are celebrating a life filled with mitzvot, and this is an opportunity for us to not only remember those we love, but also to recommit ourselves to live our lives as they lived theirs on their best days. So if you will type in the names of those you love into the social stream, if you are commemorating a Yahrzeit, if you are mourning someone who recently passed away, Please type those names in now, and then together, after we read those names aloud, we will speak the Mourner's Kaddish, which is actually a prayer that does not mention death at all. It mentions life and the promise of peace. So we, at this time, recall the loved ones whom death has recently taken from us, those who died at this season in years past, and those whom we have taken into our hearts with our own. We remember James Green, Joshua Ben Ami, BJ Seal, Martha Foote, are there any other names? The Mourner's Kaddish. Please type them now. And if you did type them and I did not read them aloud, please speak them out loud where you are. Also remember the victims of the Shoah, those victims who may not have family or friends left to remember their names. We remember all of them. The memories of all of them are with us. Our griefs and sympathies are mingled as we praise God. We pray for the coming of God's kingdom, a kingdom of peace, a kingdom of love, a kingdom of hope, a kingdom of life. Together on page 25, we say, Yekada v'yekada shemei rabba, v'yama divrach yirute, v'yam lich machute, v'chayechon v'yomechon v'chaye decha beit Yisrael, v'agalad v'zman kariv v'emru, amen. Yehe shemei rabba mevarach le'olam olam me'almaya, yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yipa'ar v'yit romam v'yit nasei, v'yit hadar v'yit ale v'yit halal shemei dikud shah v'yirchu, le'olam minko b'yirchata v'shirata, Tush b'chata v'nechemata da'amiran v'yama v'imru. Amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shmaya v'chayim aleinu v'yakol Yisrael v'imru. Amen. Osei shalom b'mramav hu ya'asei shalom aleinu v'yakol Yisrael v'imru. Amen. May the source of peace send peace to all who mourn and comfort to all who are bereaved. Together we say amen, and we close with a line from our sages that says, we must pray as if it is all up to God, we must act as if it is all up to us. And our goal, as we move through this world individually and collectively, is to make our lives a blessing. Our lives, our actions, what we choose to do on a daily basis, the mitzvot that we execute, the opportunities that we take to bring loving kindness to each other. That is the greatest of prayers. So I will see you next week on Wednesday for a Maariv service. Tomorrow evening, I think Rabbi Galit is with you. Rabbi Steve will joyfully welcome Shabbat with you as we continue celebrating the opportunity to connect through technology across the country and the world, to connect with each other, to connect with God. L'hit ra'ot, Laila Tov, and I will see you soon.